Hey everybody, it's Multiclassic Gamer here. Welcome back to more Let's Play Happy Feet. Today we're going to get them love stones, as the name of this next stage implies. It's gonna be an underwater stage.
Hey, tall boy, how about you use those smooth moves to help us collect some love stones?
Love stones? What are love stones?
It's how we win the hearts of the ladies.
The more stones you got, the better your chances with the ladies.
Sure, I'll help.
Yep, that's how you attract a daily penguins. A daily chicks is by getting stoned, I guess. No, but seriously, yeah. The reason why the female daily penguins are attracted to these love stones, as they're called, is because the daily penguins use stones to build nests, so that's why they call them love stones, is because the male penguin who has the most love stones is obviously going to have the best nest, and that's why the more love stones in a daily penguin male has, the more likely he is to win the heart of a daily chick, I guess. And that's how it works with the daily penguins, at least in cartoons. Well, actually, no. That's how it works in real life too. Is that the better nest a male has, the more likely he is to win a female over. Whereas with the emperor penguins, it's about singing. It's a matter of singing. But yeah, so basically, you just have to collect as many of these love stones as you can. And to get a gold, you need at least 45, and I've already got 23. I'll actually make that 24. I don't think I've actually missed one yet. I don't want to jinx myself, though, by saying that, but so far I haven't, so we're just fine right now. So, today is March 12, 2012. It is 5:10 p.m., and I just missed my love stone because I was not paying attention to the game. I was glancing at the clock on my laptop. In case anyone forgot, yesterday was the beginning of daylight savings time, so at 2 o'clock a.m. on Sunday morning, everyone had to set their clocks an hour ahead. And the thing is, for most of my clocks, most of my clocks are already set up to the internet, so they automatically update by themselves. Actually, pretty much the only clocks I have that do that are my laptop and my phone. That's pretty much it. All the other clocks I have to manually set the time. But that's not really that big of an issue. Okay, just 3 more and then I'll have the gold. And I think there's 50 total, if I'm not mistaken, I'm not sure about 50, but somewhere around there. Somewhere around a total of 50 love stones it is. Another thing I would like to say is that just before recording this episode, I just finished watching the movie. Yes, actually, I just watched the actual movie that this video game is based off of. And I gotta say, this movie has really aged well, even though it's only been 5 years.
Great work with the love stones, tall boy.
Gimme Finn!
And why didn't you give him Finn, Mumble? Oh, whatever. So we got 47, so we got ourselves a gold. So I guess it is 50, a total of 50 love stones, so that probably means that I missed 3. Which is no big deal, so we're going to move on. The next stage is Amigo Racing, so it looks like we're going to race the Amigos. And actually, if I do recall correctly, I actually spoiled this in the previous episode. Yeah, I did while I was doing the Sled to a Daily Land stage, so let's do the stage that I already spoiled in the previous episode.
And although a season passed and Mumble had his trusty amigos, not a single day went by when he didn't think of what he'd left behind and what may lie ahead.
Hey, big guy, you ever miss your old home?
Oh man, you had to go remind him, huh? You know that always pumps him out, talking about his old home. How about we forget about all that depressing stuff and have some fun? Come on, Stretch, let's race.
Didn't Gloria do the same thing to cheer us up previously? Like right when everyone else in the Emperor Penguin community was graduating from Penguin Elementary. Yeah. Didn't Gloria do the same thing to cheer Mumble up? I'm pretty sure that's what happened. So now they're doing the same thing to cheer us up from getting homesick, to keep us from getting homesick. So I guess that's basically, this level's pretty much the same at this. The level pretty much has the same idea as graduating from Penguin Elementary, or whatever it's called. Graduation Race, I think it's called. Which is the first stage that you played as Mumble as an adult. And crap, I just crashed into a pile of rocks there. That's not good. So, I think to get a gold in this, you have to complete the race in less than 3 minutes, which is going to be no problem for me. Because when I did this in the practice run, I completed in 2 minutes and 43 seconds, so it's not really that hard of a goal to beat. And another weird thing I found about this race is that you're not actually racing all four, or is it five? I don't know how many of the amigos there are, it's like four or five of them, I think. But I used to think that you were racing all five of them. But no, you're actually only racing one of them. And his name is Ramon, by the way. So yeah, the only amigo that you're actually racing is Ramon, even though all four of the amigos are racing with you. You're just not racing them, they don't count. The only one that counts is Ramon, so. And by the way, if you don't know, Ramon is the one with the brown hair on top. You might be able to notice that in the cutscenes, but not actually during the gameplay, so. That's probably why some of you might not understand what I'm saying there. So right now I'm in first place, and so as you can see, two of them just passed me, but I'm still in first place. So that basically proves it right there, is that you're only racing one of them, which is kind of strange. And if that's true, then how come all the other ones are sledding with us if we're only racing one of them? That never actually made sense to me. And I just run into them, and I bounce up into. Whoa! What the heck just happened there? I went like, I hit an invisible wall, and then I slide straight down to the ground on the invisible wall. That made no sense at all. That must have been like a glitch or something that just happened. A minor one, but still. Well, there's always going to be at least one minor glitch that I encounter in almost every Let's Play I do. And there we go. We just completed the race.
So you're like a great dancer and a great sledder? That just don't seem fair, huh, fellas?
Nope, unfair.
Absolutely! You have too much talent for one pinguino.
Oh, pinguino, eh?
Hey, Fluffy! That was loco extreme!
I don't know if you could see Ramon in that cutscene, but yeah, he's the one with the brown hair on top. So I got 2 minutes and 48 seconds, so that's... I didn't beat the time that I got my practice run, but that doesn't matter since I was concentrating mostly on the commentary. And also, I think what also kind of screwed me up as far as beating my time goes, it could have been the glitch that happened halfway through the race, but whatever. Okay, so for the third and final stage of this episode, we're going to encounter some aliens, it looks like. What the heck are they talking about, aliens? I don't know. Could this be like a penguin version of Independence Day? Who knows? I guess we're about to find out.
Hey man, you guys wanna go for a swim or something?
Absolutely.
Let's go.
Yeah, there's Ramon right there. That's the one that we were just talking to. And, okay, so this level is actually really, really short. And, wait a second. Oh wait, never mind. I thought something else was supposed to happen, but I think that's gonna happen after, at the cutscene that you get at the end of this, so, yeah, I was wrong. But yeah, this level usually takes like only, wait, No, actually, I'm wrong. I thought this level was like a minute long, but actually, that's how long, that's how much time I had left when I finished the level my previous in the practice room. Why am I doing so horribly in this? Probably because I'm focusing more on the commentary, but that's fine. It's better to have, to me, it's better to have really good commentary and sucky gameplay than it is to have really good gameplay and sucky commentary. So that's personally, that's the most important part to me. So, I know there's something else I want to talk about, but I keep forgetting what it was going to be. Besides the fact that I just finished watching the movie that this game is based off of, even though I just mentioned that in the first stage we took on this episode. But yeah, and the thing about it is that's actually, I'm pretty sure it's been like a year or two since I last seen that movie. And I also think it's been a year or two since I played this game as well. So that's what's so weird about it, is that all of a sudden, actually, I'm playing this game again, and that's, I think it has, I'm pretty sure it had mostly to do with that review I saw on IGN.com is what got me playing this game again, and not only that, but also maybe want to do a Let's Play of it, so that I could hopefully change the public's opinion on this game, because really, as I've said way too many times already, this game deserves a lot better credit than it got on IGN.com. Oh crap, I just got my first silver of the Let's Play. Well, we're not gonna freak out about it for now. We're just gonna continue on. Actually no, this is gonna be the end of the episode. That's right, I forgot. So that's gonna be it for episode 6 of Let's Play Happy Feet. But before we go out, there's something else I wanted to talk about. I forgot what it was called. Dang it. What was it? I know there's something on my mind, but I want to... It's something to do with the movie. I'm not sure. Something to do with the movie or the game? Wow, I can't really remember, okay? So I think I'm going to have to talk about it in the next episode. So, next time on Let's Play Happy Feet, we will go to the Collapsing Caverns, as the next stage is called, okay? And we'll find out what happens there, okay? So... Speaking of that, how come we didn't encounter any aliens? Why was the last stage named Alien Encounter if it had nothing to do with them? Pretty much all it was just us going for a swim. That's what Ramon talking about, just going for a swim and then we're swimming through a level and then we get to the end of it and there's no cutscene at the end that has to do with aliens. That makes no sense. They called it Alien Encounter and there was in the stage had nothing to do with aliens. That is just weird, but whatever. So I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Happy Feet. Thanks for watching. I'm MultiClass Gamer signing out. Goodbye. Have a great day.